local I-Team investigation is revealing the dangers of so-called medical tourism. Last night, we met a Mid-South woman who could not afford weight loss surgery here.
So she went to Mexico instead and came back with a potentially deadly superbug. Tonight, Jenny DiPrizio with advice from the experts on the do's and don'ts of medical tourism.
It's called medical tourism. Every year, thousands of Americans leave the country and head to places like Mexico for medical procedures. The reason, it's much cheaper. In Tamika Capone's case, her health insurance wouldn't cover the almost $18,000 weight loss surgery here in the United States. So she went to Mexico and paid cash. The same surgery cost her just $4,000.
Nobody wanted me to go. My husband didn't. My daughter didn't. They was like, don't go. Don't go to Mexico. Don't go to Mexico.
But that didn't stop Tamika Capone from boarding a plane in Memphis in October and flying to San Diego, California, where she then crossed the border to Mexico on a medical transport bus. She took a selfie with others on the trip. They were all heading to Grandview Hospital in Tijuana to have gastric sleeve surgery. She says she quickly realized things were done differently there.
They didn't use gloves. And I thought, maybe there's something they use that we don't use in the U.S., maybe on their hands.
Days after returning to the United States, she learned her wound was infected with an antibiotic-resistant bacteria called Pseudomonas. Earlier this month, the Centers for Disease Control issued a warning telling people not to go to Grandview for surgery until the outbreak was over.
Now I'm at risk, you know, for my life, because I chose to go to Tijuana.
Because she had surgery in Mexico, her insurance isn't paying for follow-up procedures. Capone's medical bills are piling up.
The insurance may not cover you at all, so you may have saved a small amount and then forfeited a large sum of money by having a whole lot of uncovered procedures to fix the problem here.
Dr. Steve Threlkeld is a local infectious disease specialist. He added, if there are complications, you may have more than insurance problems.
Surgeons here may be reluctant to wade in and work on that problem because they may not understand fully what the surgeon there did.
Threlkeld says if you choose to take a medical tourism trip, check to see if the facility is accredited by the Joint Commission International, which means it's held to higher standards.
You know what you're getting in terms of the procedure, the doctor, the equipment that they're using, and the facilities in which you're getting them done, you can have confidence that they've been looked at and been kind of verified.
He says after the surgery, make sure you get complete copies of all your medical records before you leave the other country. So if you have a complication in the U.S., doctors here can see what was done.
I know there's people that need this surgery.
Capone's advice, don't be cheap when it comes to your life.
Try to save your money to get an in-state doctor so that you don't have a risk like I did.
Capone met with her infectious disease specialist Thursday afternoon in Little Rock. The two are trying to figure out what happens next. For the Local I Team, I'm Jenny DiPrizio.